Chemotherapy can cause several side effects. Patients need to be prepared for nausea and possible vomiting, severe flu-like symptoms, body aches and pains, including a mild fever below 101 degrees. Possible fatigue and hair loss is possible in the future.
You will likely receive pre-treatment medications while in the infusion center that help to prevent possible nausea or vomiting, and sometimes an antihistamine medication to reduce the potential for an allergic reaction. You may also receive prescriptions to manage potential side effects that you may experience after you go home. We recommend having prescriptions filled before the first day of treatment, so they're ready if they're needed. Be sure to have a working thermometer at home to monitor temperature for fever after your treatment.
Notify your provider of any changes in your medicines, over-the-counter medication, and herbal or vitamin supplements you're taking. We advise taking medications if you have even mild nausea. Don't wait until you're sick because the medication will be harder to keep down. When the nausea fades, start with bland, simple meals such as soup, crackers, or toast. The more treatment cycles are completed, the greater the potential for other side effects that can cause problems with red or white blood cells and/or platelets. These side effects may require reducing the dose or frequency of treatment and may also require additional medications. The side effects that involve blood cells will be monitored by the lab work done prior to each treatment.
Although not all practices utilize the same telephone system, you will need to be ready to provide the practice with the necessary information for them to best respond to your concerns. Examples of information you may want to provide include your full name and date of birth, the name of your healthcare provider, the date of your last treatment, the reason for your call, and the best number to reach you.
If you are calling to report symptoms, you will want to include when they began, the severity of the symptoms, and anything you may have tried to treat them.
Let's see how this works. Ms. Lopez awoke in the early morning with fever and chills. Chemotherapy was given 4 days ago, and it was the patient's fifth treatment. As instructed, the patient took her temperature and it was 101.9 degrees Fahrenheit. As instructed by the practice and infusion nurses, she placed a call to the practice.
Hi, this is Ms. Lopez. My date of birth is May 5th, 1975. I see Dr. Chen. My last treatment was Friday, and today I woke up with fever of 101.9 and chills. I tried to lower my temperature by taking Tylenol about 2 hours ago, but my temperature is still 101.7. I can be reached at 415-555-7022. Please call me back.
The practice nurse reviews this patient's message, recent clinical history, and the healthcare provider's orders to have a clear understanding of the patient's status. The practice nurse will then call the patient to help address any concerns.
Ms. Lopez, this is Mike. I'm a nurse calling from the UCSF Cancer Center in San Francisco. I received your message and understand you have a fever, and it's been 1 week since your chemotherapy.
Yes, I woke up early this morning with chills and a fever. My temperature then was 101.9. I took some Tylenol, but my temperature is still almost the same. Let's see, that was about 4 hours ago. I didn't call until 8 because I was hoping the Tylenol would work.
Given that you have a central line in place and have had 5 chemo treatment cycles, we need to thoroughly assess you for a possible infection. Dr. Chin may want to give you IV antibiotics after you have blood cultures. How long will it take you to get to the infusion center?
It takes about an hour. My husband is working from home today, so he can bring me. Should we leave now?
No, I need to confirm with Dr. Chen that this is what we need to do and check the infusion center for a time that's available. I'll call you back in about 30 minutes. Are you having any other problems? Pain at your line site, cough, or diarrhea?
No, other than the fatigue and nausea just after treatment, I felt okay yesterday, but I woke up like this.
I will let you go and call you back in about 30 minutes.
The practice nurse confers with Dr. Chen and confirms that blood cultures and labs will be drawn. An antibiotic will be administered in the infusion center. The practice nurse obtains the necessary written orders and calls the infusion center to discuss the emergent add-on visit for this patient. If there is a delay in arranging the infusion center visit or treatment, the practice nurse will call and check in with the patient to let the patient know what is going on.
Ms. Lopez, I have an appointment for you in the infusion center at 1:30. It's a little after 10 now, so you have time to get here. Go directly to the infusion center and check in. The infusion nurse will do the blood draws necessary and then administer the IV antibiotic. I need the name of your pharmacy and the phone number in case we need to call in prescriptions.
Okay, 1:30 is fine. I use the Berkeley Pharmacy and the number is 510-432-1200. Thanks for setting up my appointment.
Glad you called promptly so we can get this cleared up. Call again anytime.
Managing chemotherapy is a team effort and includes your personal support team as well as your clinical team. At the Cancer Center, your clinical team includes some or all of the following team members. Attending physicians, consulting physicians, and nurse practitioners manage your care from diagnosis through treatment. These practitioners are also referred to as healthcare providers. Practice nurses provide procedure support, education, and care management advice. Infusion nurses administer chemotherapy and, if ordered by your physician, will administer antibiotics, blood transfusions, hydration, in other words, fluids, or other medications to support your therapy. Pharmacists review your medications for possible interactions and prepare chemotherapy in the infusion and transfusion centers. Clinical Research Coordinators, or CRCs, provide information on clinical research protocols recommended to you by your physician and then assist with data collection, infusion scheduling, and treatment during the protocol. Medical assistants assist you and your healthcare provider and nurse during your clinic or infusion center visit. Practice assistants schedule your visits and coordinate any insurance or authorization needs. Front office staff greet you and assist you with checking you in for your visit. Nutritionists assess your nutritional needs, weight loss, and dietary management. Social workers assist with financial and service applications in addition to providing emotional support. Psychologists and psychiatrists who are part of our psycho-oncology services are available to help you deal with the stresses and depression associated with cancer and its treatment. Chaplains and spiritual care. Dealing with illness and uncertainty can be extremely challenging. Many people find that talking with a chaplain can help during this period. Patients, families, and staff are encouraged to call a chaplain when experiencing feelings of fear, anger, loneliness, helplessness, anxiety, grief, or loss, or when they just need someone to talk to. Chaplains are also available for times of celebration, prayer, and rituals. Meditation rooms are available at both the Mount Zion and Parnassus campus on the first floor. In addition to your healthcare team, we have a variety of services to assist you. The Ida and Joseph Friend Cancer Resource Center, located on the first floor of Mount Zion campus, is part of the UCSF Helen Diller Family Comprehensive Cancer Center and supports wellness and healing by providing patients, families, and others with information about cancer treatments, emotional support, and community resources. The center maintains a library of books and other media, provides access to the web and health databases, and offers personalized research assistance. The Cancer Resource Center hosts activities including support groups, exercise classes, and workshops such as the Peer Support Program that connects new patients with cancer survivors who have had a similar diagnosis or treatment experience. Hours are from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., Monday to Friday. To contact the Cancer Resource Center, call 415-885-3693 or visit the website. Art for Recovery, located on the first floor of the Mount Zion campus, is dedicated to enabling patients and caregivers to express what they are feeling through their own creativity as part of a healing process. Family members, partners, and friends of patients may participate, as well as create their own art related to a loved one's illness. The art created by our cancer patients is exhibited throughout the Cancer Center. Hours are from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., Monday to Friday. To view the scheduled activities, you can also go to the website. Osher Center for Integrative Medicine, located across the street from the Mount Zion Cancer Center, offers both patient education and treatment services, including complementary and integrative care that combines the best of alternative therapies such as acupuncture, massage, meditation, herbs, and nutrition with conventional medicine to promote good health and treat illness. Specific programs for cancer patients and their caregivers are available in addition to traditional Chinese medicine. If you participate in complementary therapies, it is important to talk with your doctor or nurse about your interest and how this can be best integrated into your care. If you have an interest in exploring complementary therapies, an integrative medicine consultation at the Osher Center can help you to find the best therapies for your personal situation. The UCSF Patient Health Library is located on the first floor of the Mount Zion campus within the H.M. Fishbon Memorial Library. This library has medical books and journals, health newsletters, and more, plus access to internet resources. More importantly, a professional medical librarian is available to help you research your health information questions. Hours are 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., Monday to Friday. To contact the library, call 415-885-7285, stop by the library, or send an email to patientlibrary@ucsfmedctr.org. The self-care management strategies we've discussed in this video will help you to evaluate how you are doing and to take appropriate action. If you have already adopted these strategies, you are well on your way to being in control of your own healing process. Let's review the 7 steps in managing the complexities of chemotherapy treatment. 1. Understand your situation. Understanding your diagnosis, treatment plan, goal of treatment, and potential problems will help you to feel more confident. Your healthcare providers and their nursing staff will help you to understand the particular issues you will be facing. 2. Organize your medical and insurance information. Use your binder and carry it with you to your visits. This will help you track your treatment, response to treatment, and insurance coverage. 3. Identify your personal support team. Choose a personal advocate to help you from your family or friends, and work on completing your advanced directives. 4. Create a directory. a list of your personal and medical team members with contact information. 5. Daily self-assessment. This is particularly important during your chemotherapy treatments and helps us to know how you are doing. 6. Journal your status. This helps you and your advocate to deal with questions or problems. 7. Speak up and ask questions. Asking questions is an important way to communicate your needs. It's also the best way for us to help you understand the goals of your treatment. We are now at the end of this education program. You have had an opportunity to get a brief look at the services and staff here at the UCSF Helen Diller Family Comprehensive Cancer Center.